The Law of One, unabridged transcription of contact between the L&L Group and registered trademark, and the social memory complex known as RAW. Session 17. I am RAW. I greet you in the love and the light of the infinite creator. Before we communicate by answer, we shall correct an error which we have discovered in the transmission of our information to you. We have difficulty dealing with your time-space. There may again be errors of this type. Feel free to question us that we may recalculate in your time-space measurements. The error we have discovered concerns one of the arrivals of both the Orion Group into your planetary sphere of influence and the corresponding arrival of emissaries of the Confederation. We gave dates of 2600 years for the Orion entry, 2300 for Confederation entry. This is incorrect. The recalculation indicates numbers 3600 for Orion entry, 3300 for Confederation entry. We communicate now. Questioner, thank you very much. I wish to say again, consider it an honor, great honor, and also a privilege, as my inaudible. And I would like to reiterate that my questions may sometimes go a little off because I keep going on something that I had already started to work into the applications of the Law of One to better understand primarily the free will principle and further distortions that we discover. I got three questions just now in meditation. I'll ask them first before we continue. First, we are now in the fourth density. Will the effects of the fourth density increase in the next 30 years? Will we see more changes in our environment and our effect upon our environment? I am RAW. The fourth density is a vibrational spectrum. Your time-space continuum has spiraled your planetary sphere and your, what we would call galaxy, what you call star, into this vibration. This will cause the planetary sphere itself to electromagnetically realign its vortices of reception of the in-streaming of cosmic forces expressing themselves as vibrational webs, so that the Earth will thus be fourth density magnetized, as you might call it. This is going to occur with some inconvenience, as we have said before, due to the energies of the thought forms of your peoples which disturb the orderly constructs of energy patterns within your Earth, spirals of energy which increases entropy and unusable heat. This will cause your planetary sphere to have some ruptures in its outer garment while making itself appropriately magnetized for fourth density. This is the planetary adjustment. You will find a sharp increase in the number of people, as you call mind-body-spirit complexes, whose vibrational potentials include the potential for fourth vibrational distortions. Thus, there will seem to be, shall we say, a new breed. These are those incarnating for fourth density work. There will also be a sharp increase in the short run of negatively oriented or polarized mind-body-spirit complexes and social complexes, due to the polarizing conditions of the sharp delineation between fourth density characteristics and third density self-service orientation. Those who remain in fourth density upon this plane will be of the so-called positive orientation. Many will come from elsewhere, for it would appear that with all of the best efforts of the Confederation, which includes those from your people's inner planes, inner civilizations, and those from other dimensions, the harvest will still be much less than that which this planetary sphere is capable of comfortably supporting and service. Questioner, is it possible to help an entity to reach fourth density level in these last days? I am RAW. It is impossible to help another being directly. It is only possible to make catalyst available in whatever form, the most important being the radiation of realization of oneness with the Creator from the Self, less important being information such as we share with you. We, ourselves, do not feel an urgency for this information to be widely disseminated. It is enough that we have made it available to 3, 4, or 5. This is extremely ample reward, for if one of these obtains fourth density understanding due to this catalyst, then we shall have fulfilled the Law of One and the distortion of service. We encourage a dispassionate attempt to share information without concern for numbers or quick growth among others. That you attempt to make this information available is, in your term, your service. The attempt, if it reaches one, reaches all. We cannot offer shortcuts to enlightenment. Enlightenment is of the moment, is an opening to intelligent infinity. It can only be accomplished by the Self, for the Self. Another Self cannot teach learn enlightenment, but only teach learn information, inspiration, or a sharing of love, of mystery, of the unknown that makes the other Self reach out and begin the seeking process that ends in a moment, but who can know when an entity will open the gate to the present? Questioner, in meditation a few nights ago I had the impression of a question about a crater in Russia. I believe it was in Tunguska. Can you tell me what caused the crater? I am raw. The destruction of a fission reactor caused this crater. Questioner, whose reactor? I am raw. This was what you may call a drone sent by Confederation which malfunctioned. It was moved to an area where its destruction would not cause infringement upon the will of mind-body-spirit complexes. It was then detonated. Questioner, what was its purpose in coming here? It was a drone designed to listen to the various signals of your peoples. You are, at that time, beginning work in a more technical sphere. We were interested in determining the extent and the rapidity of your advances. This drone was powered by a simple fission motor or engine as you would call it. It was not the type which you now know, but was very small. However, it has the same destructive effect upon third density molecular structures. Thus as it malfunctioned we felt it was best to pick a place for its destruction rather than attempt to retrieve it. For the possibility probability modes of this maneuver look very, very minute. Questioner, was its danger both blast and radiation? I am raw. There is very little radiation, as you know of it, in this particular type of device. There is radiation which is localized, but the localization is such that it does not drift with the winds as does the emission of your somewhat primitive weapons. Questioner, I believe that analysis of the trees in that area has shown a low radiation level. Is this the reason for such a low radiation level in the trees? I am raw. This is correct. The amount of radiation is very localized. However, the energy which is released is powerful enough to cause difficulties. Questioner, then was the Confederation responsible for Earth receiving nuclear power? I am raw. It is a point which one cannot judge. What is cause? The basic equation which preceded this work was an equation brought through by a wanderer dedicated to service to the planet. That this work should have become foundation for instruments of destruction was not intended and was not given. Questioner, can you tell me who that wanderer was that brought through the equation? I am raw. This information seems harmless as this entity is no longer of your planetary third density. This entity was named Sound Vibration Complex, Albert. Questioner, thank you. Can you tell me who, before incarnation into this density, was the one known as Jesus of Nazareth? I am raw. I have difficulty with this question as it is phrased. Can you discover another form for this query? Questioner, yes. What I meant to say was, can you tell me if Jesus of Nazareth came from the Confederation before incarnation here? I am raw. The one known to you as Jesus of Nazareth did not have a name. This entity was a member of fifth density of the highest level of that sub-octave. This entity was desirous of entering this planetary sphere in order to share the love vibration in as pure a manner as possible. Thus, this entity received permission to perform this mission. This entity was then a wanderer of no name, of Confederation origins, of fifth density, representing the fifth density understanding of the vibration of understanding or love. This should be fourth. Rule corrects the error in the next answer. Questioner, did you say the fifth vibration was that of love? Fifth density was that of love? I am raw. I have made an error. The fourth density being is that which we intended to say, the highest level of fourth density going into the fifth. This entity could have gone on to the fifth but chose instead to return to third for this particular mission. This entity was at the highest sub-octave of the vibration of love. This is fourth density. Questioner, when I am communicating with you as raw, are you at times an individualized entity or am I speaking to the entire complex? I am raw. You speak with raw. There is no separation. You would call it a social memory complex, thus indicating many-ness. To our understanding, you are speaking to an individualized portion of consciousness. Questioner, do I always speak to the same individualized portion of consciousness in each of the sessions? I am raw. You speak to the same entity through a channel or instrument. This instrument is at times lowering vital energy. This will sometimes hamper our proceedings. However, this instrument has a great deal of faithfulness to the task and gives whatever it is to this task. Therefore, we may continue even when energy is low. This is why we usually speak to the ending of the session due to our estimation of the instrument's levels of vital energy. Questioner, I would like to make a point clear now that I'm sure of myself. People of this planet, following any religion or no religion at all, or having no intellectual knowledge of the law of one or of anything at all, can still be harvested into the fourth density if they are of that vibration. Is this not correct? I am raw. This is correct. However, you will find few who are harvestable whose radiance does not cause others to be aware of their, what you may call, spirituality, the quality of the mind-body-spirit complex distortion. Thus, It is not particularly probable that an entity would be completely unknown to his immediate acquaintances as an unusually radiant personality, even were this individual not caught up in any of the distortions of your so-called religious systems. Questioner, when Jesus of Nazareth incarnated, was there an attempt by the Orion group to discredit him in some way? I am raw. This is correct. Questioner, can you tell me what the Orion group did in order to try to cause his downfall? I am raw. We may describe in general what occurred. The technique was that of building upon other negatively oriented information. This information had been given by the one whom your peoples called your Hwe. This information involved many strictures upon behavior and promised power of the third density, service to self-nature. These two types of distortions were impressed upon those already oriented to think these thought forms. This eventually led to many challenges of the entity known as Jesus. It eventually led to one, sound vibration complex Judas, as you call this entity, who believed that it was doing the appropriate thing in bringing about or forcing upon the one you call Jesus the necessity for bringing in the third density planetary power distortion of third density rule over others. This entity, Judas, felt that, if pushed into a corner, the entity you call Jesus would then be able to see the wisdom of using the power of intelligent infinity in order to rule others. The one you call Judas was mistaken in this estimation of the reaction of the entity, Jesus, whose teach learning was not oriented towards this distortion. This resulted in the destruction of the bodily complex of the one known as Jesus to you. Questioner, then if the entity Jesus was fourth density and there are wanderers on the planet today who came from fifth and sixth density, what was it that Jesus did that enabled him to be such a good healer, and could these fifth and sixth density beings here today do the same? I am raw. Those who heal may be of any density which has the consciousness of the spirit. This includes third, fourth, fifth, sixth, and seventh. The third density can be one in which healing takes place just as the others. However, there is more illusory material to understand, to balance, to accept, and to move forward from. The gate to intelligent infinity can only be opened when an understanding of the instreamings of intelligent energy are opened onto the healer. These are the so-called natural laws of your local space-time continuum and its web of electromagnetic sources or nexi of instreaming energy. Know then, first, the mind and the body. Then as the spirit is integrated and synthesized, those are harmonized into a mind-body-spirit complex which can move among the dimensions and which can open the gateway to intelligent infinity, thus healing self by light and sharing that light with others. True healing is simply the radiance of the self causing an environment in which a catalyst may occur which initiates the recognition of self, by self, of the self-healing properties of the self. Questioner, how did Jesus learn this during his incarnation? I am raw. This entity learned the ability by a natural kind of remembering at a very young age. Unfortunately, this entity first discovered his ability to penetrate intelligent infinity by becoming the distortion you call angry at a playmate. This entity was touched by the entity known as Jesus to you and was fatally wounded. Thus the one known as Jesus became aware that there dwelt in him a terrible potential. This entity determined to discover how to use this energy for the good, not for the negative. This entity was extremely positively polarized and remembered more than most wanderers do. Questioner, how did this aggressive action against a playmate affect Jesus in his spiritual growth? Where did he go after his physical death? I am raw. The entity you call Jesus was galvanized by this experience and began a lifetime of seeking and searching. This entity studied first day and night in its own religious constructs which you call Judaism and was learned enough to be a rabbi, as you call the teach learners of this particular rhythm or distortion of understanding, at a very young age. At the age of approximately 13 and one half of your years, this entity left the dwelling place of its earthly family, as you would call it, and walked into many other places seeking further information. This went on sporadically until the entity was approximately 25, at which time it returned to its family dwelling, and learned and practiced the art of its earthly father. When the entity had become able to integrate or synthesize all experiences, the entity began to speak to other selves and teach learn what it had felt during the preceding years to be of unworthwhile nature. The entity was absolved karmically of the destruction of another self when it was in its last portion of lifetime and spoke upon what you would call a cross, saying, "Father, forgive them for they know not what they do." In forgiveness lies the stoppage of the wheel of action, or what you call karma. Questioner, then, in which density does the entity known as Jesus now reside? I am raw. This information is harmless though unimportant. This entity studies now the lessons of the wisdom vibration, the fifth density, also called the light vibration. Questioner, in our culture there is a great saying that he will return. Can you tell me if this is planned? I am raw. I will attempt to sort out this question. It is difficult. This entity became aware that it was not an entity of itself but operated as a messenger of the one creator whom this entity saw as love. This entity was aware that the cycle was in its last portion and spoke to the effect that those of its consciousness would return at the harvest. The particular mind-body-spirit complex you call Jesus is, as what you would call an entity, not to return except as a member of the Confederation occasionally speaking through a channel. However, there are others of the identical congruency of consciousness that will welcome those to the fourth density. This is the meaning of the returning. Questioner, you spoke of the alleviation of karma being forgiveness. RR. I'm having a hard time phrasing this question. I think I'll have to come back to it. I'll ask this other question. Can you tell me why the earth will be fourth density positive instead of fourth density negative after the cycle is complete, since it seems that there is a greater negative population? I am raw. The earth seems to be negative. That is due to the quiet, shall we say, horror, which is the common distortion which those good or positively oriented entities have towards the occurrences which are of your space-time present. However, those oriented and harvestable in the ways of service to others greatly outnumber those whose orientation towards service to self has become that of harvestable quality. Questioner, in other words, there will be fewer negative entities being harvested into fourth density than there will be positive. Is this correct? I am raw. This is correct. The great majority of your peoples will repeat third density. Questioner, how did Taras Bulba, Genghis Khan, and Rasputin get harvested prior to the harvest? I am raw. It is the right privilege duty of those opening consciously the gate to intelligent infinity to choose the manner of their leaving of the density. Those of negative orientation who so achieve this right duty most often choose to move forward in their learned teaching of service to self. Questioner, is this the reason for what we call spontaneous combustion? I am raw. This is not correct. Questioner, can you tell me what causes that phenomenon? I am raw. Picture, if you will, a forest. One tree is struck by lightning. It burns. Lightning does not strike elsewhere. Elsewhere does not burn. There are random occurrences which do not have to do with the entity, but with the window phenomenon of which we spoke. Questioner, are these particular entities all uniquely the same, or are they just random entities? I am raw. The latter is correct. Questioner, am I to understand that the harvest will occur in the year 2011, or will it be spread? I am raw. This is an approximation. We have stated we have difficulty with your time-space. This is an appropriate probable possible time-space nexus for harvest. Those who are not in incarnation at this time will be included in the harvest. Questioner, well, if an entity wants to learn ways of it, wants to be of service to others rather than service to self while he is in this third density, are there best ways of being of service to others, or is any way just as good as any other way? I am raw. The best way to be of service to others has been explicitly covered in previous material. We will iterate briefly. The best way of service to others is the constant attempt to seek to share the love of the Creator as it is known to the inner self. This involves self-knowledge and the ability to open the self to the other self without hesitation. This involves, shall we say, radiating that which is the essence or the heart of the mind-body-spirit complex. Speaking to the intention of your question, the best way for each seeker in third density to be of service to others is unique to that mind-body-spirit complex. This means that the mind-body-spirit complex must then seek within itself the intelligence of its own discernment as to the way it may best serve other selves. This will be different for each. There is no best. There is no generalization. Nothing is known. Questioner, thank you very much. I don't wish to take up extra time by asking questions over again. Some are so important I try to ask some similar questions in different ways to expand on the answer. Seems to be inaudible what we're getting at, maybe not. In the book OAHSPE it states that if an individual is more than 50% for others, that is, goes over the 50% service to others, and is less than 50% for service to self, then he is harvestable. Is this a correct statement? I am raw. This is correct if the harvesting is to be for the positive fourth dimensional level. Questioner, what must be the entity's percentage, shall we say, if he is to be harvested for the negative? I am raw. The entity who wishes to pursue the path of service to self must attain a grade of 5, that is 5% service to others, 95% service to self. It must approach totality. The negative path is quite difficult to attain harvestability upon and requires great dedication. Questioner, why is the negative path so much more difficult a path to attain harvestability upon than the positive? I am raw. This is due to a distortion of the law of one which indicates that the gateway to intelligent infinity be a gateway at the end of a straight and narrow path, as you may call it. To attain 51% dedication to the welfare of other selves is as difficult as attaining a grade of 5% dedication to other selves. The, shall we say, sinkhole of indifference is between those two. Questioner, well, then if an entity is harvested into fourth density with a grade, let's say, of 51% for others, 49% for self, what level of the fourth density would he go into? I'm assuming there are different levels of the fourth density. I am raw. This is correct. Each enters the sub-density which vibrates in accordance with the entity's understanding. Questioner, how many levels do we have here in the third density at this time? I am raw. The third density has an infinite number of levels. Questioner, I've heard that there are 7 astral and 7 devashanic primary levels. Is this correct? I am raw. You speak of some of the more large distinctions and levels in your inner planes. That is correct. Questioner, well, who inhabit the astral and who inhabit the devashanic planes? I am raw. Entities inhabit the various planes due to their vibrational nature. The astral plane varies from thought forms in the lower extremities to enlightened beings who become dedicated to teach learning in the higher astral planes. In the devashanic planes, as you call them, are those whose vibrations are even more close to the primal distortions of love light. Beyond these planes there are others. Questioner, well, does each doze this is difficult? Our physical plane, are there 7 subplanes to what we call our physical plane here? I am raw. You are correct. This is difficult to understand. There are an infinite number of planes. In your particular space-time continuum distortion there are 7 subplanes of mind-body-spirit complexes. You will discover the vibrational nature of these 7 planes as you pass through your experiential distortions, meeting other selves of the various levels which correspond to the energy influx centers of the physical vehicle. The invisible, or inner, third density planes are inhabited by those who are not of body complex natures such as yours. That is, they do not collect about their spirit-mind complex as a chemical body. Nevertheless, these entities are divided in what you may call an artificial dream within a dream into various levels. In the upper levels, desire to communicate knowledge back down to the outer planes of existence becomes less, due to the intensive learned teaching which occurs upon these levels. Questioner, then is it necessary to penetrate one plane at a time as we move from what we call third density physical through these planes? I am raw. It has been our experience that some penetrate several planes at one time. Others penetrate them slowly. Some in eagerness attempt to penetrate the higher planes before penetrating the energies of the so-called lower or more fundamental planes. This causes energy imbalance. You will find ill health, as you call this distortion, to frequently be the result of a subtle mismatch of energies in which some of the higher energy levels are being activated by the conscious attempts of the entity while the entity has not penetrated the lower energy centers or sub-densities of this density. Questioner, is there a best way to meditate? I am raw. No. Questioner, at this time, near the end of the cycle, how are reincarnations into the physical allocated, shall I say, on this planet? In our own, inaudible. I am raw. Entities wishing to obtain critically needed experience in order to become harvestable are incarnated with priority over those who will, without too much probable possible doubt, need to re-experience this density. Questioner, how long has this been going on, this type of allocation? I am raw. This has been going on since the first individual entity became conscious of its need to learn the lessons of this density. This was the beginning of what you may call a seniority by vibration. Questioner, can you explain what you mean by a seniority by vibration? I am raw. This will be the final question of this session of working. The seniority by vibration is the preferential treatment, shall we say, which follows the ways of the law of one which encourages harvestable individuals. Each individual becoming aware of the time of harvest and the need on a self level to bend mind, body, and spirit towards the learned teaching of these lessons, is given priority in order that this entity may have the best possible chance, shall we say, of succeeding in this attempt. May we ask at this time if there are any questions? Questioner, my only question is there anything we can do to make the instrument inaudible? I am raw. This instrument is not wearing the appropriate apparel for this work, as in pourings occur in the regions of the, what you may call, seventh chakra as you speak of these energy centers, filtering through the sixth and so forth, the entity's other or base chakras become somewhat de-energized. Thus, this entity should be more careful in its selection of warm apparel for the part of the body complex you call the feet. May we answer any other brief questions? Questioner, just we want to put heavier clothing on the feet. Is this correct? I am raw. This is correct. I will leave this instrument now. I leave you in the love and the light of the One Infinite Creator. Adonai. End of session 17. The Law of One.